Concorda, when it comes to the National Broadband Plan, my absolute priority has always been to ensure that high-speed broadband is provided to more than 540,000 households and more than 1.1 million people in rural Ireland who do not currently have access to this essential service. No more and no less. I'm absolutely satisfied that there has been no interference in the procurement process by me. The political and media frenzy in the last week has been deeply unhelpful. Commentary by those who are not procurement experts that this process is dead in the water and that the final bidder does not have the capacity or capability to roll out the MBP is incorrect and has been deeply damaging. Commentary such as this is where the real risk and interference with the MBP arises. The use of language is inflammatory, inaccurate and inconsidered. It calls into question the integrity, ability and impartiality of my officials and the external advisers who have managed this procurement process and the integrity and capability of the last remaining bidder. We cannot halt the procurement and engage in discussions with parties that had previously been involved in the MBP procurement process, namely Air and Ciro. This is simply not an option that is open to the government, nor is it necessary, even if it were open to the government. If we had to reset the clock, it would set the NBP process back years. Insofar as meetings are concerned, on the 26th of June, I attended a meeting in Leinster House at the request of my officials with representatives of the remaining bidder. I was accompanied to that meeting by the Secretary General, Assistant Secretary with Responsibility for Communications, the Chief Technology Officer and Special Advisor. I'm making available the minutes of that meeting on my department's website. The position currently is that the final tender submission for the National Broadband Plan was received from the remaining bidder in the MBP procurement process on the 18th of September. Since then, evaluation of the final tender submission has been ongoing by the MBP evaluation teams in my department to assess the completeness, compliance and robustness of the submission and to evaluate the submission against the technical and commercial award criteria. The fact is that the MBP procurement process is subject to very strong oversight, where the department has the assistance of expert external advisers and is supported by a procurement board and a steering board with external expertise with an independent process auditor in place. I understand the evaluation process is expected to conclude by the end of this month, at which stage a recommendation will then be made to government. The real risk for the NBP now lies in loose language and irresponsible politics at this critical time in the MBP process. Cancorla, I met with the Taoiseach last night and earlier today offered the following to allay concerns of the opposition on some of the issues that have recently arose. This comprised of a confidential briefing by senior members of the procurement team, the project sponsor, the programme director, the chief technology officer and the process auditor to the opposition spokespeople. The Secretary General of my department will write to the opposition spokespeople in this regard. A review, perhaps by a former Secretary General, of my role, if any, in the MBP procurement. And to address, if there is a concern from the opposition, that I would in any way second-guess the outcome of an independent process recommended to me, the assignment of responsibility for the MBP procurement to the Minister of State, Sean Kine, in the department, who already has responsibility for a number of functions in the communications area, or to another Cabinet-level minister. This was not accepted by on Taoiseach, who asked me to reflect on my position. It is clear to me, therefore, that the Taoiseach does not have confidence in me. That confidence does not exist, even though I, as Minister, have introduced the first Climate Change National Mitigation Plan and National Adaptation Plan, secured over €22 billion in the National Development Plan for Climate Action, established a Climate Action Fund with an allocation of €500 million to leverage additional public and private investment in climate action measures, developed a much higher and credible profile for Ireland at EU and international level on climate issues, introduced a settled waste policy, including the introduction of incentivised pricing for waste disposal and a comprehensive suite of measures for food waste management, provided a new funding package for over 400 anti-dumping initiatives right across this country, established the Mobile Phone and Broadband Task Force, drawing together the industry, government departments, the regulator, and developed a comprehensive suite of measures to deal with mobile phone black spots, had the lead role in developing a government response to issues in relation to online safety, funded an accelerated rollout of digital skills and trading online supports for small and micro business, secured a rescue package of €30 million for Onpost to address its severe difficulties and set it back on a path to recovery, provided additional funding for the broadcasting sector of over €17 million and legislation that would address the funding issues of regional broadcasters, provided an increase of €74 million in funding for energy measures, including energy efficiency and new initiatives to help the most vulnerable who are suffering health issues due to poorly insulated housing, introducing new and innovative renewable energy and renewable heat schemes. I'm now left in the impossible, stark position that a politician never wants to find themselves in. Do I make the decision myself to resign, or wait for that decision to be made for me? And what do I do against a backdrop of the opposition not having sought my resignation? If I was a cynic, which I am not, I believe the outcome is more about opinion polls than telecoms polls. It's more about optics than fibre optics. The fact is, as Minister, I have to meet investors, whether it's in the telecoms or energy or any other sector. These are the people who provide jobs in this country. That is the context in which I had meetings with Mr. McCourt, and that's how it should be seen. The reality is David McCourt has met with every single communications minister, has met several members of this government and members of the opposition in recent years. For my family, for my constituents, and more importantly, for the 1.1 million people who are waiting for this essential service, a vital service to ordinary people in rural Ireland, I have given an Taoiseach my resignation. I wish my Cabinet colleagues well, and I would ask, most of all, that the MBP process is allowed to reach its conclusion over the next few weeks for the 1.1 million people in rural Ireland who need this infrastructure now more than ever. And can I finally assure the House that the decisions that I took as the former Minister for Communications, Climate Action and Environment were taken solely in the interest of bringing high-speed broadband, bringing communication services, mobile services to every single home, business and citizen in this country, and for no other reason whatsoever. Thank you very much, Ken Corliff.